Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me on Skype is Stanton Sloane, CEO of Frequency Electronics. Stanton, it's great to meet you.
Hi, Christine. Likewise.
The company is a New York-based aerospace company. Your products have basically, been through all areas of the solar system. It's super interesting. Tell me more about the company.
Yeah, Frequency Electronics founded 55 years ago. And we make precision, timing, and frequency generation systems, along with electronic warfare and GPS-based systems as well. The clocks, these are atomic clocks and quartz crystal clocks, they provide the primary time and frequency reference for satellites and also for other systems, not just satellites, but aircraft and other type systems.
The percentage of satellites that dominate your business, how important is the satellite business to your business?
Yeah, it's a little over half of our business in the aggregate. Frequency has two subsidiaries, but in aggregate revenue, the space represents a little over half of the business.
And talk to me about some of your customers. I know one of them is Lockheed Martin.
Yeah, we have quite an array of customers, all the large aerospace and defense companies, anybody that produces satellites. We also have direct contract work with the U.S. government, and we provide space subsystems for some of the commercial satellite companies overseas as well.
One of these is called Northrop Grumman Innovation Systems. You recently delivered a fourth in your series of wide area augmentation systems. What does that mean, and why is this important?
So wide area augmentation, or WAS, is basically an FAA system. It's used to provide augmentation to the GPS navigation signal for aircraft. It provides precision approach capability based on GPS. And so if you fly in the U.S. airspace system, in all likelihood, your aircraft will use WAS to make their precision approach at your destination.
This is a company that's a subcontractor on a satellite that will be launched in 2021. Can you kind of talk about what they're working on?
Well, our role is to provide the WAS subsystem, which is part of the satellite payload. So you have, of course, for any space system, you have the satellite builder, and satellites typically have a bus or the basic structure of the satellite, and then the payload is the WAS payload, which provides the navigation signal.
I understand. Besides satellites, you're working on new opportunities for next generation atomic clocks. What does that mean?
So we do rubidium atomic clocks and also precision quartz oscillators. They're used not only in satellites but for secure communication systems, for anything that requires precision timing or frequency generation. And in our case, we have patented technology, which is used in the oscillators to produce frequency references for very precise frequency measurements. That applies to aircraft, ships, a variety of other platforms.
So what's next for the company? What can we expect? What can investors expect in the next few months or so?
So we're developing some evolutionary products. One example would be the rubidium atomic clock, which we produced for space applications. We're developing a digital version of that clock, which is a significant advancement in the capability. Another project which we have underway is the optically pumped rubidium atomic frequency standard, which again is an order of magnitude improvement in performance of the basic clock system. Those are underway now and are being funded some by government or commercial customer R&D and also by internal R&D funding.
You did increase your fiscal 2019 revenues by 61% compared to the prior fiscal year. What should investors really be paying attention to?
Well, I think they should be paying attention to the new developments and their application for some of the advanced space systems. We, of course, make press releases whenever we have good news, and I would say the investors watch the press releases because we have some exciting contracts coming up.
Definitely looking forward to it, Stan. Really interesting to talk to you. Thanks so much.
Great. Pleasure talking to you, Christine.